Hello, everybody. Welcome to 10-Minute Tutorial for Research. Today, we'll talk about selling your quantum solutions on AWS Marketplace. My name is Nihit Pokhrel. I'm a partner solutions architect in the high performance computing team. And I'm joined today by Joseph Shi, who's a partner solutions architect in AWS Marketplace team. In the next 10 minutes, Joseph will do a quick presentation about AWS Marketplace, and then I'll follow up with some frequently asked questions. Joseph, over to you.
Thank you, Nihit. So AWS Marketplace is a curated digital catalog for third-party software where you can find, buy, deploy, and manage third-party software, data products, as well as services to build your businesses on. So we're going to talk about how you as a seller of quantum algorithms can sell your products on Marketplace. And Marketplace has different product types, and that those kind of dictate how you would package your product. So in general, the product types that we have, there are two main categories. And the first is that the products and software that deploy directly into the buyer's AWS account. So these are software that run in the buyer's account without the seller's involvement. And the first group we have are single AMIs, and AMIs are Amazon Machine Images. They are your virtual machines that can be deployed onto EC2 instances in the AWS account. And EC2 Elastic Compute are services that can run virtual machines. We also have container product types in Marketplace, and container Docker container images that can deploy in the buyer's AWS account. There is also SageMaker resources, such as model package and algorithms that can also be deployed into the buyer's account. Then you have product types that are hosted and maintained by the sellers. And these include the SaaS, where the buyers will directly consume the product in the seller's account without having to deploy any infrastructure in the buyer's account. There's also the API datasets for AWS Data Exchange. AWS Data Exchange is a feature in AWS Marketplace where data providers can sell their data in various ways. And one of them is via an API that they would host. So today we're going to focus mostly on the AMIs, containers, SaaS, and the API datasets. How to package an AMI, the Amazon Machine Images, is you have your instance, your VM that's running, and you create an image based off that. That image is then given to Marketplace, and when buyers go and subscribe to it, they're given access to take that image and deploy it onto an EC2 instance to run that virtual machine. There's also single AMI with CloudFormation, and CloudFormation is a way to describe and deploy services in AWS. So you may have AWS services such as a relational database. You might have some storage services that you're using that your software depends on. So any of those can be bundled into the product. So you would provide us a template, and those are then made available to the buyers to deploy the AMI along with those additional services to provide that one-click experience. There's also multi-AMI, and the only difference here is that you have multiple different instances and you want to publish multiple different images into the marketplace. And those also are accompanied by a template that can help deploy those instances and other AWS services that the software needs. Moving on to containers, packaging containers in AWS Marketplace. The containers that are published into a repository that's hosted by AWS Marketplace. So when you go into your packaging motion, you would push container images that your buyers would need into this repository managed by AWS Marketplace. And your buyers who have subscribed would have the ability to pull those images and to help them deploy it on the various container orchestration platforms available to them in their account. You as a seller can provide them with deployment templates. So those can be Helm charts, those can be usage instructions, those can be CloudFormation templates, anything that'll help them deploy that onto clusters that they're gonna run your containers on. Your software will also need to integrate with AWS Marketplace APIs for some billing integration there. For SaaS, when the buyer comes to AWS Marketplace, they agree to purchase upfront your SaaS contracts or agree to your price list when they sign up for your SaaS product. So SaaS products are hosted in your seller account. So this is not something that they would deploy into their buyer account. There isn't really any infrastructure for them to deploy. Everything is done through you. So in that case, the buyer, after subscribing, would then be redirected to your landing page, your SaaS application. Your SaaS application would then need to capture a token that they can call the APIs with to find out who the customer ID is, who the customer is, and the customer ID and the product that they have purchased. With that information, you can call another API to understand what did the buyer purchase up front, and how many units of that did they purchase. Furthermore, with that same customer information, you can then report additional usage that is outside of the contracts, or if it's a subscription product where it's all purely pay-as-you-go, then you would report those usage to AWS Marketplace so that Marketplace can then charge the customer on their bill. There's also a SNS topic, which is simple notification service that you can subscribe to keep up to date of any changes to their subscription or the contracts they have purchased. And furthermore, once any changes happen, you can call our APIs again to understand what they have upgraded to or any changes in that case. There are API data sets for AWS Data Exchange. So AWS Data Exchange allows data providers to provide data in various ways, one of which is an S3 bucket, for example, where if I have a bunch of CSV files, then I can put them into an S3 bucket and list and publish that through AWS Data Exchange, and the buyers would then pull those data files out. Now, what if I, as a seller, want to publish more of the dynamic data? Then you, as a seller, you can then publish an API instead. So this is very similar to the SaaS way, except with the API data set, you don't really need to manage the identity. There really isn't a token for you to capture to understand who the customer is. What you essentially need is just an Amazon API gateway that will be in front of your application and to have responses to receive requests and respond in certain ways that the data exchange expects. And what's behind the API gateway is anything you would like to use. So that could be Lambda functions that connect to other services and DynamoDB. So this is very similar to how SaaS is done, except that you don't have to manage about each individual user. You will get some identifiers that come through the API gateway, but then the idea is that you're just providing that service. So it's everything's proxied through API gateway, and you don't have to worry about identity in this case. And that brings us to the close of our different prototypes.
Thank you, Joseph. Now I have a couple of questions that customers and partners have asked me before. We will paste the links to some of these answers to some of these questions. So please do not worry about writing everything down. The very first question, can I offer free trials for my software offering?
Yeah, that's a good question. Depending on the product type, there are some free trial features. For example, the AMI product type, you can set up a free trial where the buyer is not charged your software fee for X amount of days, and they can run one instance, for example. In other product types, there's different ways to do free trials, and some product types don't support free trials. So it really depends on that and that product type.
Okay, thank you. And what about billing? Will AWS bill my customers directly?
Yes, so AWS Marketplace's expectation is the buyer will pay AWS Marketplace, and AWS Marketplace will then provide the software that's deployed into the buyer's account. If it's a SaaS, then the buyer will then go to your SaaS to consume the product. But AWS Marketplace will handle the billing and allow buyers to then pay with one AWS bill. So that's also a benefit for buyers.
Okay, thank you. Now a couple more questions, and these are quantum specific. So where will my solution be listed? Is there a designated page where quantum computing solutions will be listed on Marketplace?
There isn't a quantum computing category page or list of products in Marketplace today. However, I believe it's going to go under high performance computing at the moment, and in the future that may change.
Okay, thank you. Knowing that quantum is a very new field, it's an emerging technology, and every engagement involves some kind of professional service and consulting services. So in this case, can I list my quantum focused professional services on Marketplace?
Yes, you can. The only requirement is that you have some software product on AWS Marketplace, and then you can publish a professional service listing on Marketplace and then charge for professional services on top of your software solution.
Okay. All right. Thank you. One more question. Say if I wanted IP protection guaranteed from AWS Marketplace, what method should I pick?
Yeah, that's a very interesting question. So IP protection is one of a importance to the sellers often that we speak with. So looking at the different product types we have on the screen here, the single AMIs, the containers, the SaaS and the API data sets. So with the AMI product types, the buyer has full access to your virtual machine image. So that means that they can look inside look inside your volumes. They can inspect your volumes. Similar with the container images, they can inspect the layers. In fact, the container images are your run-of-the-mill Docker containers. They can be downloaded and pulled to a desktop and inspected there. So with the software that's deployed in the buyer's account, namely the AMIs and containers, there's no really a way to protect your IP there, your intellectual property. With the products like the SaaS and API data sets, those are where you can protect your intellectual property because those run inside your seller account and you expose what you want to expose to the buyer and when they consume your product.
Okay, thank you. So with all this information, as a seller, where do I get started?
Yeah, so if you go to the AWS Marketplace, you can click Sell on AWS Marketplace. This is the link at the top right, and log into an AWS account. So the only thing you really need to get a seller account is to sign up for an AWS account and agree to some terms and services. If you want to sell paid products, there are some additional steps such as your tax entity and bank accounts, but there's going to be a link in the descriptions that'll explain the requirements for setting up a seller account. So look out for that.
All right, thank you. That's all we had, Joseph. Thank you for joining us and answering questions about AWS Marketplace.
Absolutely. Thank you, Nahit.